The first laboratory experiment is on measurements and significant figures. The purpose of this presentation is to give you the same information that I would if this were a campus class. I'd give you a little bit of an introduction so that you had a feeling for what you'd be doing in the experiment, and I'd warn you about some of the pitfalls, give you some hints and tips so that the laboratory flowed a little more easily. First of all, just something general about online labs and how they work. You'll be using the published laboratory manual, and when you're asked in the manual to make an observation or to gather data using a chemical valence or a piece of volumetric wear or whatever it is, you'll click on a photo and then interpret that photo to make your observation or to gather your data. So it's pretty simple, not high-tech at all, and it works well. One of the first things that you'll do in this experiment is to cut out rulers, ruler A and B, that you'll use to measure some objects. And if you've rented your lab manual or if you bought a used lab manual, you may not have that page in your book. If you find yourself in that situation, send me an email and I'll scan that page and send it back to you. We use ruler A in part A of the experiment, and ruler A has markings to the ones. And one general principle of significant figures is that whenever you use a measuring device, you can estimate one more place than the number of markings. So for example, if I had something that was this long, well, I know I'm sure of the one, and it's not quite over there to the two, I can estimate maybe it's 1.5 or 1.4, something like that. In other words, every time you take a measurement with ruler A, you should be recording one more place to the tenths. As we grade the experiment, that's one of the easy things we look for. We look at all the data in part A and make sure that every value is to the tenth. Let's look at ruler B. Ruler B is a little more precise. It has markings to the ones, and then it also has markings to the tenths. So now let's follow the same rule. We can estimate one more place than the number of markings. That means that we should record every measurement with ruler B to the hundredth. Something like this, 2.84. I'm sure the 2.8 and the 4, the last digit, is always an estimate. It's a little more than 8, not quite up to the 9, and so we estimated it to be 2.84. If I felt it's a little hard to do, because when you use ruler B, you'll see that these lines are pretty close together. So very admittedly, it is an estimate. If you felt something was right on the line, 2.8, you might be tempted to record 2.8, but that would be wrong. You still have to record to one more place than the number of markings, and so the correct response would be 2.80. This is a little bit of a tip now for part C. We've seen that ruler A can be recorded to the tenths, ruler B to the hundredths. And if you're doing an experiment now and want to gather data as accurate as possible, which ruler would you use? Well, the answer is ruler B. So make sure that you use ruler B in part C. Then I just want to warn you a little bit about the entire experiment. It's awfully easy to write down a quick response when you're asked how many significant figures something has. But go slow. Review that section in the text. So that you're very familiar with significant figures and make sure of your responses. Because the overall strategy for the class is to do well in the labs, to do well in the quizzes and the tutor activities, so that those will enhance your grade and not bring you down. Just a little bit of review now for significant figures. Adding and subtracting are different operations than multiplying and dividing. So they have different rules between these two sets of actions. When you're adding and subtracting numbers, you count decimal points, and the lowest number of places wins. When you're multiplying and dividing, you count significant figures, and the lowest number is the one that you use. Let me give you two more tips. I'd like you very much to watch each of these laboratory videos, so I'll make sure that I give you some hints and tips that will save you some points as you work the experiment. It'll save you one or two or three or maybe more points on the experiment. In part A, one of the things that you may find yourself doing is taking a measurement and converting it to one significant figure. How would I do that? Well, 10.7, if I round it off to 11, I've still got two significant figures. And the way we treat significant figures, even if I rounded it off to 10, this zero is a trailing zero, and in our text, we count trailing zeros as significant. So we still have two significant figures. The only way I can take this measurement and record it in one significant figure is to use scientific notation. 1 × 10^1. In scientific notation, we only count these digits ahead of the time sign as being significant. Here's one more tip. In part C, you're measuring coin thickness, and you come up with some values, perhaps with two significant figures, and maybe some values with three significant figures. And now if you're going to take that information and you want to use the best value to calculate the volume of a coin, which would you use? Well, we want to use the one with the most significance, wouldn't we? A synonym for significance is meaningful. So we want to use the most meaningful number that's available to us. Hey, have fun with this lab.